the first time they've ever worn the West Hancock Titans basketball jersey. But talking to the players, you wouldn't know it.
We've already had a, you know, pretty good success with football, and I've already played with a bunch of the guys from here, so I know it was a pretty easy meld so far.
I know some of the guys pretty well, and you know, we hung out a lot together this summer and through the fall, so it's a pretty cool experience to be the first.
Head coach Reno Pinkston will call the shots on the sidelines, along with former Hamilton head coach Dan Belt as his assistant.
Coach Belt's coached us for 2 years now, and he has the same style of coaching as Coach Pinkston and Coach Griffiths. Between the three of them, they've all won a state championship, and they know how to do it, and it's just exciting to know that they can show us the way to go.
What to watch for? Well, the inside presence of West Hancock. Will Carr and Caleb Gray form the tumultuous Titan Towers.
We've had to alter according to what we have, and Will's the biggest kid I've ever coached, and Caleb is extremely strong. So, you know, we've got to use that to our advantage, obviously. So we'll be more oriented to the post than
we
have been.
The other side of
this
co-opted tournament is the Southeastern Suns Classic. The winner of this bracket plays the winner of the Q&D bracket for the overall title belt. Early line favorite on this side, a brand new co-op for the West Hancock boys. We all know how this triple threat worked for the girls last year. They went on to win state. So Reno Pinkston and his new triple threat West Hancock co-op looking to do the same this year. And if you got Reno on the sidelines, you got a good chance of winning state every year. Ryan Runge, he had a big night for Mr. Pinkston. He makes it 29-16 in the second half with a triple right there. Drew Miller with a nice bucket down low. The left hand, nicely done. Crafty scoring from number 33, Will Carr inside. Big night for Will Carr, and he's also a big guy, 6'8". He gets the bucket and the harm. He would make the free throw for a three-point play. Then Carr playing some D with a nice block on the other end. It's Runge making the layup, and West Hancock goes on to win this one by 9, 52-43.
Tonight saw West Hancock and Giddy going at it. Reno Pinkston and the Titans gunning for their second win. And as many nights, how about a dunk, the first of the year, courtesy of Caleb Gray. Yes, we had it. We had plenty of people saying, did you shoot that? Yes, we got it. Underneath, though, this guy had an outstanding night for Unity onto the evening. That's Josh Gronewald onto the night. He finished with 24 points. Later on, it's more, however, from West Hancock as Ryan Brunen getting that one to drop in for three. The shot miss here from Sean Mahaffey there with the putback for Unity. But West Hancock and Dylan Morris, who also had a nice night, 15 points to the rack he goes. West Hancock wins big, 82-57. Your final score is both they and the Suns are 2-0 in that event. Elsewhere on the.
Notre Dame play. West Hancock taking on Southeastern in Augusta tonight. Ryan Brennan underneath, and he's going to get the bucket right there. Excuse me, from outside. That's a three-pointer for the Titans. They would be off to an early lead in this one. Then Sean Grosinek also stepping outside. He matches you tit for tat on that one. And then a little bit later, it's going to be Caleb Gray coming in. He's going to get the board. He fights hard in there. You're going to be hard-pressed to find someone who's going to push him out of the lane. Gets the putback right there. But Southeastern's going to try to get back in this. They're going to go to their weapon. It's that man. It's Reagan Bringer. He's got guns from outside. He hits that three-pointer. But Dylan Morris and company, led by Ryan Runge tonight in scoring, would get the job done. That's right, it is West Hancock getting the win. They will face Q&D tomorrow in the championship game, 66-54. Tip-off Suns Classic. It's West Hancock taking on Quincy Notre Dame. They're playing at the pit, bringing back the old school introductions at the pit, and then it's Ryan Stuckman. Good defense leads to good offense. Gets the bucket right there, and Notre Dame is off and running in the early goings. Tyler Durst, a little bit later, is going to be the recipient of this pass from Tim Haley. He's going to step behind the arc, and he's going to bury the three-pointer. Quincy Notre Dame came out blazing. Reno Pinkston and company were frustrated, but Ryan Brunin would get things going. He knocks down the triple right there for the Titans, and they would slowly claw their way back into this one. Dylan Morris then, a crossover to the rack. He gets that one. Titans cutting into the lead. In fact, Will Carr, the big fella, would even get himself a dunk as he puts that one down. But tonight was Notre Dame's night as Durst knocks down another three, and they were rocking as they win the Gully Tip-Off Suns Classic Championship 52-37.
Going West Hancock, the opponent, revenge from the semifinals of the Suns Classic. How about the 2-4 Southeasters? They would get it going with Cody Jefferson with that steal. West Hancock, however, countering Dylan Morris out to Ryan Runge. He had led all scorers with 19 points on to the evening. Regan Bringer gonna feed down low, and it's what color, Roland Kirker there with the baseline two that gets the Suns off where they want to be. Morris, how about this floater in the lane? Off the window, good as gold for Morris. Back with more from Southeastern. It's Reagan Bringer as he would go to the rim. Check out the nice move. An outstanding young junior is Bringer, but too much of Nate Parker and West Hancock. They win by the final score in this one of 43-34 of getting that second win over Southeastern this season. Also, Camp Point Central at home.
field game. And we'll start with the entry pass to Will Carr, the big fella. He gets the easy deuce for the Titans. A little bit later, it's going to be a steal by Dersick Betzer. And Betzer's off and running for Pleasant Plains. He gets the easy layup. The Cardinals were pumped. In fact, they had a 10-3 lead early on in this one. But Wes Hancock would pick up the D. Dalton Mann going up, and he would get the easy basket right there. Wes Hancock would cut into that lead, and then they'd even get a little further into it. Good pass ahead to Caleb Gray. Caleb with a three-point play, but the Titans would still be down at half. Dylan Morris would then try to turn it on. He goes to the 10. He had 8 points, but he did leave the game with an ankle injury. And then Pleasant Plains, they're just going to be too much. Joel Harney with the three here, 44-29, sending Reno Pinkston squad into the loser's bracket. Illini West will be joining them in the
Hancock in the second round, but Reno Pinkston's team was in for a bit of a surprise today, courtesy of Pleasant Plains. How about this? The Titans trying to work the ball inside early with mixed results. To Will Carr there, successful, but this entry pass is picked up by Derek Betzer of Plains, and Plains was off to a 10-3 start in this ball game. After the timeout, however, the Titans would come out and look a little better. Great steal right here from Dalton Mann. He goes floor length and throws the teardrop in. Then it's Caleb Gray in the low blocks doing what he does, posting up and playing big. A three-point play the traditional way. Still, the Titans struggling to find their game today from the outside. Ryan Runge lights up a three. West Hancock was back to within three. Dylan Morris trying to make his presence felt. This kid is so good off the dribble, and you see it on back-to-back occasions right here. But after that first quarter flourish, the bottom would drop out. Here comes Dylan Morris one more time as it's the back-to-back buckets. But the bottom, as I said, quickly fell out. How about a little John Ellenberg right here for Plains from the outside? This team, 2-7 coming in. They may be the best 2-7 team in the state. Later, it's Nick Venturini. The Titans held today to just 29 points. Reno Pinkston won't be pleased. 44-29 is your final, and we will have no Pittsfield West Hancock rematch. Elsewhere today.
Of the end of the world, but it's feeling just like every other morning before. Now I wonder what my life is gonna mean if it's gone. The cars are moving like a half a mile an hour, and I started staring at the passengers and waving goodbye. Can you tell me what was ever really special about me all this time? But I believe the world is burning to the ground. Oh well, I guess we're gonna find out. Let's see how far.
Let's see how far.
sting of a first-round loss to Pleasant Plains in the Macomb Western Holiday Tournament seemed to wear off quickly for West Hancock. The Titans won its final three games of the event, then took a week off after playing five games in 10 days. With the rushed show, Western the opponent tonight. Will Carr and company looking strong early. Look at the big fella underneath getting the board, putting the two up and in. West Hancock not done. They'd be heard from this man, Ryan Runge, from the baseline. Three more. And Reno Pinkston squad looking strong. However, Western coming right back. Tyler Harris, he led the Wildcats with 19 points. What a year he's putting together. All-state caliber year, I would say. Carr with another putback up front for West Hancock. Western, however, would go also to their big fella underneath. It's Cole Rubel working the thing down low with the left hand. How about Western squeezing out a win on the road? Big win for the Wildcats, 47-45, your final score. Other boys' scores from tonight, Illini West.
Is where we will start tonight. The last time Jeff Dahl and Reno Pinkston coached head-to-head was back in 1999 in a highly contentious regional title game at La Harpe. Much has changed in the decade since. Heck, who would have thunk we ever saw Warsaw kids playing for Reno back then? But the constant here has been coaching ability, and both gentlemen have their teams rolling again this season. Jeff Dahl, happy to be home in front of a packed house at the Wright Fieldhouse. A little strange, Dan Belt coaching against his former head coach in this game right off the bat, though. It's good to see Will Carr back, and he was a monster in the low blocks for the Titans tonight, paying big dividends on the first two possessions. First of all, with the offensive putback, then getting away from the defenses, which is what he did. Later, it's a 7-0 run capped by this. Ryan Brunen, three right there. And as I said, Titans start off 7-0. Finally, Josh Beard comes up and takes the goose egg off the board for the Chiefs, but they could never overcome a cold start in this game. Dylan Morris contributing to the problems for the Chiefs right here. Great take as he knifes right through the middle of the defense for the easy finger roll there. Ahmad Carter had a big night in a losing cause tonight for the Keokuk Chiefs. You see him here with the steal and the bucket and the Brinks job and the bunny at the other end. He had 15 points tonight, but just too much of the Titans, who played maybe their most complete game of the season. Max Schlicker right here. beautiful finish for him as the Titans roll on to win by 10 tonight. 57-47 was your final.
And his West Hancock team, they're hot as of late. Ryan Brunen taking it in. He hits the nice jumper, does Ryan on that play. Then we're going to go over to Pittsfield. How about Brad Hamilton? Nice little shake and then a bake. That is an acrobatic circus shot by Brad Hamilton. Nicely done. Kyle Harris stepping outside. You know he can hit the three. He's pretty tall, but that makes no difference. Stands out there and hits. Speaking of tall, how about we go to Will Carr underneath? That's right, the big fella, 5'4", getting the layup for West Hancock. How about the end of the first overtime? That's right, we're in overtime. Look at this, buzzer beater. Wow, Brad Hamilton, as you hear the buzzer. Oh, give me a chest bump, buddy. Max Schlicker, though, he would get things going. The Frost doing good things, gets the jumper right there. And in the second overtime, Dylan Morris seals the deal. What a game. West Hancock gets the victory, 47-45.
Let's start with a playoff quality pairing over in Hamilton as West Hancock taking on Liberty in this one. Ryan Brunen driving down low, hitting Dylan Morris, who kisses it off the glass. Liberty has an answer, though. Blake Berry over to cousin Eric Berry, who a little hard on the shot, but gets the roll. Will Carr later on, though, for West Hancock, showing everyone that he's 6'9" and using it. Great swat. Then after a double team, it's Carr back out. And then over to Max Schleicher, over who hits the long jumper. And then Mac finding Carr inside. Great way of getting open. Carr had 14 points on the night. Later for Liberty, Sam Orman over to Josh Tank down low. However, at the end of the first, now Ryan Brunen driving. And then he'll hit the nice fallback shot for this one. West Hancock holds on to win 44-37. A Subway Superfan shootout over Pittsfield, and the West Hancock Titans are rolling lately. Today, though, the tough tasks continue for Reno Pinkston and company as Canton comes across the border into Illinois, coming into town. Great matchup in Canton and West Hancock, and then this Canton jumping out to an early start. Nathan Ohlmeyer pitches ahead to Colt Carper, who hits the tough jumper right here. And then how about Justin Ellison? He's been huge for the Tigers this year. Off the inbounds pass, way to take it back in. But West Hancock would be a little bit too much in this one. Ryan Runge pulling up for three, no problem for him, and he wouldn't be done. Runge with a huge day behind the arc. He'll hit another three there as well. And then Tigers come back. Ellison hits a cutting Colt Carper for the jumper. But how about some more West Hancock? This is Max Schlicker for a three. It's just a three-point contest here. It is NBA All-Star Weekend, you know. Then another three later on from Ryan. Colt Carper and Canton trying to answer with a three of his own. You think there's a theme in this game right here, guys? Another three-pointer here. And then Ryan answers with another three of his. Tell you what, Will Carr, West Hancock, all these three-point shooters, they would prevail in this one. West Hancock takes down Canton by a final. Oh, we don't have, or 64-38. Macomb.
We head up to Hamilton tonight. West Hancock taking on Canton. Max Schlicker underneath, that's Will Carr. And Will Carr is going to put it in as West Hancock would be off to an early lead. A little bit later, Schlicker to Ryan Runge. Oh, was this kid hot tonight. 7 3-pointers. Get that kid a Valentine. 28 points to lead all scorers. Trying to get Canton back in was that man, Colt Carper. He would do most of the scoring for the Tigers. 17 points on the affair. Nathan Ohlmeyer then dishing off to Justin Ellison from beyond the arc. Justin hits the three-pointer right there. Then it's going to be more from West Hancock. Schlicker to Dylan Morris. Dylan with the easy layup. West Hancock gets the victory, 64-38. We head now to... We'll be right back.
Hancock won their final 7 regular season games heading into tonight's start to regionals. It's a good thing the Titans have just 3 losses in the last 2 months. One of those came against tonight's opponent, Illini West. You know, the girls met up in this same matchup to the start of regional play for both. So do the boys. Will Carr saw him at a gas station in Keokuk today. Wished him luck. He supplies the 2 right there. This is coming back with Illini West. Zane Schmudlock, part of the brothers Schmudlock, nailing that from trifecta land. Ryan Runge had himself a night. How about this shot from beyond the arc? Finished with a team-high 18 points. Jacob Schmudlock, however, wanting to do his thing, and he would. A little fadeaway inside of the key. He had a game-high 28. Did the outstanding junior. Max Schlicker going to answer for West Hancock, and the Titans would prevail in the end. Good game, 67-61. West Hancock, like the girls, winning in that match.
Like a Orange Crush traveling party tonight to Rushville. But could the Bombers, vertically challenged as they are, stop the 6'9" Will Carr? Well, early going, Will Carr with some intimidation. But look at Davis Hendrickson, the reigning KHQA Student Athlete of the Week, using that left hand to good effect. Seth Wickert came out of the gates, just amazing tonight. The point guard outside for 3. Then how about a little larceny and layup from Seth Wickert? Just a sophomore, but he played big tonight. Dan Watson's crew seizing an early opportunity, and they were like sharks in a water full of chum. They just kept attacking. Look at that. Matthew Gordy off the window, and it's a 9-0 run to start this game. Will Carr would finally stem the bleeding right here. but it wouldn't last for long. Will Carr taking it up strong at that point. How about a little more Davis Hendrickson right here with another steal? He's just so quick, and that left hand is lethal as he gets the lay-in. It's 13-2, got as bad as 16-4 in the game in favor of McComb on this Davis Hendrickson three off the creation. Nicely done by Seth Wickard. But in the second quarter, all Titans. And when I say Titans, I mean big Titans. And I mean Will Carr, who had himself a second quarter for the ages tonight. He just simply took over this game and willed his team all the way back him into it. Will Carr in triplicate right here with three big highlights. And when it wasn't Will Carr, it was Caleb Gray as Wes Hancock erased that entire 12-point deficit, came back and tied it at 22 at the half. But in the second half, McComb pulls away in this ball game, and the Bombers are advancing. Danny Watson's team is headed back to Rochester, where we saw him a few weeks ago, and their opponent will be Decatur St. Teresa.